Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'du. Before we start the second high training, inshallah, diberkahi barakah. Syekh Abdul Majid going to recite a few verses from the Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وأتم الحج والعمرة لله فإن أحصرتم فما استيسر من الهدي ولا تحلقوا رؤوسكم حتى يبلغ الهدي محله فمن كان منكم مريضا أو به أذى من رأسه ففدية من صيام أو صدقة أو نسك فإذا أمنتم فمن تمتع بالعمرة إلى الحج فما استيسر من الهدي فمن لم يجد فصيام ثلاثة أيام في الحج وسبعة إذا رجعتم تلك عشرة كاملة ذلك لمن لم يكن أهله حاضر المسجد الحرام واتقوا الله واعلموا أن الله شديد العقاب الحج أشهر معلومات فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج وما تفعلوا من خير يعلمه الله وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقون يا أولي الألباب ليس عليكم جناح أن تبتغوا فضلا من ربكم فإذا أفضتم من عرفات فاذكروا الله عند المشعر الحرام واذكروه كما هداكم وإن كنتم من قبله لمن الضالين ثم أفيضوا من حيث أفاض الناس واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم فإذا قضيتم مناسككم فاذكروا الله كذكركم آباءكم أو أشد ذكرا فمن الناس من يقول ربنا آتنا في الدنيا وما له في الآخرة من خلاق ومنهم من يقول ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار أولئك لهم نصيب مما كسبوا والله سريع الحساب واذكروا الله في أيام معدودات فمن تعجل في يومين فلا إثم عليه ومن تأخر فلا إثم عليه لمن اتقى واتقوا الله واعلموا أنكم إليه تحشرون صدق الله العظيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وَهَلَ لُقْدَةً مِنْ لِسَانِ يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِ. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who give us many of blessings and all the blessing that Allah still give us chance now, still alive. And inshallah we continue until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, fulfill our goal, you know, to visit His house and visit Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ameen. And alhamdulillah, so last week we described everything that connected to the, in Arabic, called ahkam, to the ruling regulation of the Hajj, and it's very important in order that to be accepted. There's two condition. What's the two condition? Your niyah had to be correct, and second one, you have to do it accordingly. Suppose your niyah is good, but not accordingly. Yeah. And before we talk about the secret of the Hajj, just want to mention a few things that in the Hajj they have called arkan, pillars, and they call wajibat. Pillars, arkan, and wajibat. What's the difference between arkan? Mal farqu bayna arkan wal wajibat? Al arkan law la natabi'ha al hajj yakun batil. If you don't do it, the hajj is batil. For example, among the rukun of salat is what? Is takbiratul ihram, right? You just pray bismillahirrahmanirrahim, risal invalid. Ruku, sujud, right? The dua istiftah surah is not rukun. Your salat still complete. And the hajj, the first rukun of hajj is wukufi arafah. Wukufi arafah. That's the rukun. That means if you miss wukuf arafah, your hajj is invalid. You have to go back next year. And the second rukun of hajj is tawaful ifadah. Tawaful ifadah. If you miss tawaful ifadah, you have to repeat again. Right? So therefore, for the sister, it's very important because you connected with the airplane. So make sure that during tawaful ifadah, you are clean. Right? If not, the difference between wukuf arafat, if you miss tawaful ifadah, you can come back again to Makkah. But that's take years, maybe take months, maybe. Right? The others, wajibat. What wajibat mean? If you don't do it, you can pay a ransom, dam. Ihram, for example. Ihram min al-wajibat, you have to bring ihram. Suppose, you know, many happen sometimes, I don't know, I don't want it to happen to you. You forget your ihram on the bag, not on the carry-on. So you are in Beirut now. You didn't have ihram, right? So what you have to do is okay, just continue, but you have to pay a dam. Get it? Or for some reason you cannot stay in Mina because you are sick. I won't stay in hotels. Yes, you can pay dam. You understand me? Yeah. So the rest is called wajibat. Stoning, you cannot stone, for example. Somebody can stone for you if you are fresh, for some reason you have to go to Jeddah or somewhere, you can pay the dam. But wukuf and tawaifadah, you cannot pay by dam. Because what? That's rukun. Right? Then we have sunnah of the hajj. We'll talk about that, inshallah. Right? So this is the principle. So basically, this is the stage that you're going to do. So of course, you know, the first thing you do is wearing the ihram. That's in miqat. You know, everybody, inshallah, this year will be from Beirut, wearing ihram. Right? And then of course after finish ihram, you arrive in Jeddah and then you go to tawaf. What tawaf is one? What type of tawaf is this? Tawaf qudum and tawaf umrah combined. Tawaf qudum and tawaf umrah. Right? And then sa'i. Tawaf and sa'i is always together. Right? When you make tawaf for umrah, you make tawaf for a hajj, you have to combine. Mean you cannot just tawaf only. You'll be tawaf and sa'i. You understand, right? But regular tawaf, you're not wearing ihram, you don't need to be sa'i. You understand? You stay 5 days maybe in Makkah, right? After we finish umrah. Then every day you go to tawaf. You're wearing any cloth. Tawaf, no sa'i. So basically, sa'i only twice. Sa'i what? Only twice. Sa'i of umrah and sa'i of hajj. There's no sa'i after that. Halas. So that means you only do sa'i when you are in the set of ihram. Right? Tawaf anytime you come to masjid, you can make tawaf. It's good. Make a lot of tawaf. Right? Anytime you come to masjid. So finish a sa'i. This is Not the stead we began to do last week, explain. From here where we go to Mina, right? So that's one is sunnah, right? So just one look at the number here, and then after finish tawaf, sa'i, you do umrah, right? So when it's time for hajj, the first thing you wajib is go to Arafah. That's the wajib. So mostly Indonesian didn't go to Mina. They go to Dayak to Arafat. From Bangladesh, go to Dayak to Arafat. Right? We follow sunnah, we go to Mina first because we make preparation. Because we, you know, from Mina to Arafat is closer, and also we are already ready. So we are in Arafat, and then from Arafat, you go to the Muzdalifah. Right? Muzdalifah. From Muzdalifah, you have two choices. From Muzdalifah, you go back to Mina for stoning, or from Muzdalifah you go direct to Makkah for Tawaf Ifadah. Tawaf Ifadah. You understand? You can go direct to Mina, stone, and then go to Makkah. Or from Muzdalifah we go to Makkah, make Tawaf Ifadah. Finish Tawaf Ifadah, you go back to Mina for stoning. Right? Next week, I will explain to you about what will be our program, step by step. Right? So, finish tawaf, khalas, that's number seven. What's the rest now? What after tawaf finish? Everything's finished, right? Done, right? Only one, what's that? Right? If the viha finish all this, what's the last thing? Tawaf, wada, free will, to say bye-bye. That's the last one, right? So this is in general about ahkam, and we spent last week, right? So now we talk about the secret of the hajj, right? You will not able to understand about hajj unless you know the story of Prophet Ibrahim, Ismail, and Hajar. So when you go home, please search and study about them. Because Hajj have strong connection with these three. And by the way, Allah wanted when you go to Hajj, like in Hollywood. What people do in Hollywood? Making movie, right? And Allah wanted you to be an actor, an actress. So you have to be like Ibrahim, right? When he's stoning, right? He want you to be like Ismail, like Hajar. And I'll explain to you that. So that means you are Ibrahim, no? You are Hajar, no? You are Ismail, no? Right? That's what Allah wanted. Right? So knowing the story of them is very important. In Ibn al-Quran, Allah SWT said, رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ دُرْيَةِ بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْءٍ إِنَّ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ. When Ibrahim reached Makkah, he made this dua: Our Lord, inni I am askantu, mean dwelling. You know, you put me in a place, min duryati, with my wife and my baby. Biwadin, in the valley. Makkah is valley, so therefore when there is a flood, it will be drowning, because Makkah is very low, and it's all a mountain. You come from everywhere, before they have the building, you can see Kaaba. Because you are from the top like this. That's valley. Ghairi dhi zara'in, when there is no fruit, nothing. Yet, in the baytikal muharram, you know, in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbana liyuqimu s-salah. Oh our Lord, I wanted this place, a place to establish salah. Faj'al afidatan minan nasi tahwi ilayhim. Allah, please make the heart of the people attached to it. Love it. Right? This is dua I accepted. You know, sometimes you're traveling, maybe to Gujarat, to London, to a places, and you have a bad experience. You know what you say? I never go again. I never in my life. Oh man, right? Did you hear somebody Even with all difficulties, said, I never go to Makkah again. Never. Even with all difficulties, he said, I want to go back again. Right? Even my children, when last year I brought my twins, I said, when we go back? Subhanallah. Yeah? This is dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Warzukhum min al-thamarat, and provide them with the fruits. Do you understand this dua? Makkah, there's no single tree. And we dua what? Allah bring the fruit. And you will see that all kind.
It is in Makkah, but there's no single, right? Because the dua prophet Ibrahim alaihissalam, right? That Allah is good and me make them to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now why Ibrahim alaihissalam is so important? Because Ibrahim is have two symbols. Symbol of tawheed and symbol of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah wanted you to make sure when you put your heart, the most important is tawheed. It's only one God. Even if we read in the many du'a, nah, lebaik Allahumma lebaik, lebaik Allah, syarika laka lebaik. There's no partner. And it's submission. Ibrahim, when he was born, right, he has a father. What's the father profession? Selling the stage, right? Ibrahim had discussion with the father. And then Ibrahim had to leave his father. Salamun alayka. I said, Dad, khalas. You know, that's enough. And leaving your father, your parents, not easy, right? But for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he left his father because he was disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Ibrahim alayhi salam was discussing with Nimrud, right? It was wrong. And it wouldn't be fine. You and me maybe said, Allah, okay, da'wah, okay, everything okay. But put in fire this month, right? Ibrahim alayhi salam, he accepted. And then he was alone in the desert. Alone in the desert, and Allah asked him to have circumcised. Khita. Now he's 80 years old. If you and me were to say, Allah, I know khita, you know, but I'm too old. I will say to my son. That's number one. Number two, he have excuse. What the excuse? There's no knife. Right? Allah, yeah, but you know, no knife. Ibrahim did not say that. He don't say why. He tried to find something that soft. He said he find a kudu, the donkey form. Tried to soak it. And he just can't imagine. And then he asked him for what? For a baby, right? Allah give him baby. Ismail alayhi salam. Baby became cute and they love babies so much. What Allah asked him to do? Kill the baby. Sister, if your daughter, young daughter, or son, play with knife, will you? Don't play that. Just play with knife. No, you have to kill your son, daughter, by your hand. Like this.
And then also, Ismail, you know, when he came to Ismail, you know, Inni ara fil manami anni adbahu. I saw a dream. Dream for prophet is revelation. I have to kill you. No, if you talk to your son now, son, come here. I love you so much, but Allah asked me to kill you. What your son going to say? Say, Dad, you lost your mind. You know, let me enjoy my life. You're older than me. And a doctor said you have problem with your heart, so you're going to die anyway, just right? That's Ismail. And also Ismail, he could say what? Idbahni, right? Dad, kill me. What Ismail said? He didn't say that. Ya abatif al ma tu'mar. Oh daddy, do what Allah command you to do. What is the difference between Dad, kill me? Ibrahim, Ismail want to say, oh Allah, this is not your command, not my command, not my mom's command. It's Allah's command. You don't need even ask my permission or my opinion. In other words, also, Allah, if Allah ask me before you kill me, cut my ear, take my eyes, I'm ready. So therefore, falamma aslama. No, Allah call them Muslim now. This is what Allah wanted in during the Hajj. Aslama, you submit, right? And this is the most difficult, because you go to Makkah, you have to what? Submit, wearing ihram, wearing ihram. Right? After wearing ihram, don't do this, don't this. You follow. Yeah. Okay. Tonight you go to Jamarat. Jamarat. You go to Mina, Arafat. Khalas. No question. And then also during Tawaf, maybe somebody push you. Allah, I don't care. Right? Somebody yell at you. I don't care. This is the submission. As long as I can meet you, Allah, I can be in your house. Right? Then we talk about Hajar, inshallah, later. Now, to know the secret of Hajj, we have to know what is, why Allah created us. Allah answered in Surah 51:56. He said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I created not jinn and man just to worship me. Ibadah in Islam is to show what? Our submission, right? And also our spiritual need, that we call waqood, nahtaj ila al-waqood, like a fuel. Through ibadah, Allah SWT provide us that you need waqood for every day, the 5 times a day. So when you pray, what? You put the fuel, because your iman can be cooled down. And then also you need a fuel for 1 year. When is it? Every year. What kind of ibadah? Ramadan, fasting. Right? Some only one night. What night? Lailatul Qadr. Right? And some need only one in your life. What's that? Hajj. This is special. Hajj, Allah SWT said, I need you 1 year, and you get, if you get it, khalas. You give Hajj mabrur, right? You guarantee Jannah. Right? This is the 1 year. And then in the hadith, and one of the scholars said, Ilahi kafa bi fakhran an akuna lillahi abdan. Ya Allah, I'm a proud, it's enough for me, I became your slave. What abad mean? Slave. What the plural? Ibad. In the Quran, Allah used the word abid and ibad. What's that? Abid and ibad. Everybody is abid. Everybody. Muslim, non-Muslim. Slave. Slave is our choice. But ibad, you choose to be slave. Right? When Allah talk about ibad, that means it's positive. Wa ibadur rahman. Abid, that mean willingly, unwillingly, you are what? Abid. I ask question now. What is the best age? The best age? Young age. When? What? 30, 33, right? No. Oh man, you know, I don't want to increase or to become old. Look at this old man. He cannot see very good. Can he? I want to stop my age. Can you do that? Why? Because you are abid. No choice. Can you choose your parent? You choose to be born? No. You are what? Abid. Allah said, وَمَا أَنَا بِظَلَّمٍ لِلْأَبِيدِ. Allah said, I will not do wrongdoing to abid. But Allah wanted to become what? Ibad. Right? Ibad, ya Allah, I want to be your slave. That means to be obedient to you. No, what difference between a slave and servant or employee? What different? Most of you work, right? In Boeing, Microsoft, Amazon, right? Employee or servant have job description. How many hours you work every day mostly? 8 hours. Now, slave have job description or not? If the master said, hey, wake up. He said, no, this is time finished. No, slave no choice, right? That's number one, slave no sleep. Number two, do slave have half salary? can demand something? No. You can have demand something. You increase your slave nothing. Right? Is the word slavery is good or not? It's bad, right? Look at the American slavery, right? So, but when you become slave of Allah, this is honor for you. Now I ask question now. A master, they have slave. Suppose your slave, Allah rob, that means you are owned by Allah. When you own something, you don't need anymore, what you do? For example, this computer not work anymore, what you go? You draw it, right? You have a cow, and the cow did not benefit you anymore, too old, no milk. What do? You slaughter it. You understand what I mean? If you are boss, you have employee not do good job, you fire him, right? No. Look at you in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many times we disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How many times do evil thing? What Allah do to us? Did Allah fire you? Khalas finish? No. Right? Why? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Praise be to Allah, Lord of the world. What after that? Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Because this master is so merciful. Right? Subhanallah. Even you do all the evil thing, Allah give you what? Change. Right? The problem with us, we know we are slave, but sometimes what? You want to be like boss. You act like boss, right? What time we pray Fajr? Huh? Now? Fajr is easy, no? Huh? 5:30? Okay. Some people said, oh, it's too early for me. No. If you go to the boss, you know I cannot come every day at 8 o'clock. This is too early for me. I will come every day at 10 o'clock. And I cannot give report every week. You know, I give you every month. But you cannot cut my salary. What the boss said? I don't know. Like we do to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is a pray fajr is too early for example. Yeah? So this is very important for us. Yeah? And why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us? What's the reason mostly created us? He said that in Hadith Qudsi, Kuntu kanzan makhfiyan fa ahbabtu an u'raf fa khalaqtu al-khalqa likay u'raf. He said, I was kanzan, like a treasure, makhfiyan, hiding, nobody know. So I created creation to know me. So basically, Allah created us, and Allah make us hajj for what for? Anybody can guess? By His mercy, I know. You know, in your life, you have a lot of sin, and many sin may be unforgiven. But I'll invite you to my house. You have to spend your money, spend your energy. If you get there, I will forgive you. Because how do you know that I am forgiven, right? You know, somebody said, oh man, he is generous. How do you know he is generous? You didn't know him, right? Until what? He always has to give, right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribe all his ibadat, just want to tell you that he is so merciful, he is the forgiver, right? Ibrahim alaihissalam, after he built the Kaaba, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us to go to the mountain. What the mountain called? Anybody remember? What's the mountain that Ibrahim alaihissalam called the people? Jabal Abi Qubais. Jabal Abi Qubais. Anak-anak suruh. Adul, can you ask anak-anak suruh? Ikhidi. Jabal Abi Qubais, right? Nobody there. Makkah is empty. No a single person. Ya Allah, how could I call the people? My voice cannot reach even, you know, the people in the bottom. Allah said, Ibrahim, just call. And I convey the message. This is what Ibrahim said. وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج أميك. And proclaim unto mankind the pilgrimage. They will come unto thee on foot and on every lean camel. Subhanallah. So therefore, long time ago, coming to Makkah looked like you never come back again. So therefore, the whole village will say goodbye to you, right? Because when take something what? 1 month, 2, 3 months, right? If you are from Indonesia, at least need 3 months. Sometimes you get lost. So then what? No Facebook, no cell phone. When you are in Makkah, you are totally nothing. I remember when my father, the first time went to Makkah, was writing a boat. No news. He was waiting 3 months. Do my father will come back or not? What he was praying, right? So long time ago is really, really you are going to say very well. It's very well, man. Right? No, alhamdulillah, you arrived there in Jeddah. Hey, I'm here. Yeah. And some people, sometimes be careful. You know, don't when you are in Tawaf, people stop in Tawaf. Hey, I'm in Tawaf, man. Subhanallah, we still remember people. You will see that people talking in Tawaf. Right? I'm the last one. Is the last. Yeah. Subhanallah. Right? So therefore, when he said labbaik Allahumma labbaik, that means Allah, I respond to the calling of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and I am here now. So the Hajj start by ihram. Ihram means you wearing certain cloth, right? Every ibadah have what you call it, the opening. You know, what's the opening of salat? Takbiratul ihram. When he said Allahu Akbar, what does it mean? Everything is forbidden now. Can you eat? Can you talk? And it's happened here. And during Ramadan, somebody become American, become Muslim. And then we pray I was praying Isha. I was leading a prayer. And then I think his phone was ringing. And we began to make ruku. I'm praying. He didn't know that on that day, right? Takbiratul ihram, khalas. Okay. What is the opening of the ihram of fasting? What? Niyah, right? In the morning, khalas. Suhoor, khalas. Right? So the key, everybody have key, right? So the key of Hajj is what? Ihram. Ihram means two. Niyah of Hajj and wearing a ihram. You could be wearing ihram, but it's not considered Hajj or Umrah. Without what? Niyah. Right? So basically, the best is you wearing ihram first, right? You know, we make wudu, we pray 2 rakat, and then you make intention. Because as soon as you're wearing ihram, all the restriction had to be implemented, right? Why Allah asks us to wearing ihram and we're going to meet him? You know, there's, you call in Arabic, it's called protocol, right? It's adab. When you are invited to White House, they will ask you to wear certain clothes, right? So you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because many of us, even here, everybody have different what? Status. Status because of your position, your job, your wealth, right? So Allah wanted us to forget all of that. To forget all of that. So be careful. If you're only wearing ihram, but you still have something in your heart, arrogant, pride, because of this thing, you're not wearing ihram. Right? Because ihram means what? You have to take off everything, include what in your heart. If you feel an ahsan, I am better because I am Indonesian, I am Arab, I am Pakistani, Bangladeshi, right? And or because I'm ambassador, it's happened. I was in Mina, in Arafat. I was, you know, on that time I just worked for the Indonesian, and I give instruction everybody to make line here, and somebody said, "Hey, who are you?" "I'm ambassador." Subhanallah. You, so he is in Arafat, he feel ambassador, khalas, finish. Be careful, huh? So ihram mean what? That's number one. Number two, ihram is to Allah want us to have experience when you going to meet Allah, real meeting. When is real meeting? Judgment day, when you die. What you wear when you die? You wearing ihram, khalas, that's what you have. Allah said, going to meet me, so this is ihram. Right? So ihram means forget your body, your physical. No, you have to elevate your heart. You're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the proof of that, so therefore, after you wearing ihram, what do you have to do? Allah said, you have to make peace with everybody. Because after you wearing ihram, you cannot what? Huh? You cannot use perfume. Right? You cannot talking like in the love language with your partner. Once again, you cannot kill the animal, even small insect. So you have to have you have to have adab, you know, etiquette even to the trees, right? To the animals. Halas. If you have to make you have to have peace with the animals and the trees, how about a human being, right? This is very careful. And so therefore I always mention, if you go to Hajj and you have temper before and you cannot control your temper, don't go Hajj. Right? La tadhhab ila al-Hajj. Because that's the purpose of Hajj. How to control your nafs. Wa nafsi wa masawaha. And you will blow because what? You were tired. You had a plan to go down and then you go to the bus, and sometimes over there, not like here, you know, many Americans, they are polite. Over there, yeah, you never somebody yell at you. What do you have to do, no? Allah said, be careful. Make peace with everybody, especially the one who rude at you. Because you have peace with people nice to you, it's easy. But the one rude at you. Maybe even you're in your hotel, and because everybody have, you're going to stay with somebody you never stayed before. Maybe he's snoring. What are you going to do? Hey, wake up. I couldn't sleep. Or somebody, something take restroom too long. Or you knock there, hey, this is your home? Be careful. And Shaitan will play very smart. Because Shaitan said, okay, spend your money, I will destroy you. And maybe I just talking now, and then you will see when you are there, what everything I say here will happen. People will fight for everything. And then also in Mina, in Arafat, Mina and Arafat, you go to restroom, you have to make line. Because 3 million people in the same place. And maybe you go to restroom, restroom is not clean like here. So everything will bring you, Allah will encourage you to be angry, because that's Allah wanted you. I make you difficult, tired, everything, but I want to test you. That's ihram, man, wearing ihram, right? So you have to be careful. So well, this is some of the sunnah, the step of it is mustahab to do ghusl. So because it is impossible and difficult to have ghusl in Beirut, in airport, so we make ghusl at home. And that ghusl intention for that one, right? So before you leave, you know, before you take shower, and take shower my intention for ihram, right? Take shower, right? Ghusl. And before the ghusl, one should take time to remove any unwanted hair and also to cut the nails and other fingers, tools. So make sure, because to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, you can have like a lion, right? Yeah? One should also shave off their hair under the armpit, you know? And for the men especially, it's very important. Because you are in Arafat, Mina, you're going to sleep, maybe. No? It's not good view for people, I'm sorry. Yeah? Cut off. Right? So everything. So everything that the hair is has to be cut off, right? And then you take shower and make wudu, right? And so in Beirut, you just make wudu. Make wudu. They have shower also if you want to take shower, but it's enough. This is mustahab in sunnah. It's not wajib, right? Because maybe you have fever on the time. You know, before you leave something, if you take shower, maybe it become worse. It's okay. Just make wudu, right? Is ihram? Okay. So I want to show you something. If you are from Indonesia, Bangladesh, it's easy because you're used to wearing sarung, you know. So wearing ihram, yeah. So I encourage you when you're wearing ihram is like towels, because you have to go to restroom many times. So it's because you don't wearing the either public, maybe you not feel good, and also sometimes the transference people can see what inside, right? So as you see, the first thing you do when you're wearing ihram is so you can wearing like this. So basically, there's two ways to wearing ihram, right? Is it like this? But make sure that your leg is open, because if not, after you wearing me, like like the woman wearing the this happens. So put like this, and then like this, right? Like this, and you can like this. And then you put the belt, right? Yeah. So, so the belt at the top, right? And then the second one is for the tops. Oh, thank you. So if you bring the what you call the what's called it here, pinch, huh? Pinch, yeah. For men, I think bring pins, because then, so you're wearing like this, right? Mostly sometimes I put this so it can stay, right? And then wearing like this, right? So you put the pin here so you can stay. If you know the if you have ihram from Egypt, the Egyptians already have stick in the back, right? But in the first tawaf, the tawaf wudu in Umrah, is sunnah to open, you know, your right. So, like you see in the pictures, right? To be like this. This one open. During the three law for men, it's sunnah to open this one. Historically, when the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba went for the first Umrah, the Quraysh spread the rumors that those people, you know, people from Medina, they have something, what you call it? They are weak. They are weak people, and they have something in their body. That's why they cover. You know what I mean? Something ugly in their body. So Rasulullah want to show them, right? So therefore, it is sunnah in the beginning, like jogging for men, right? So historically, to show the Quraysh, right? This is like a politic, right? People said, oh, Muslim weak. No, we are strong, look at you, right? Have something, look at, you can see our body. And people was watching in the many women and the kids through the windows.
of their houses, their closet. Wow, they are strong, right? Now become ritual. Of course, you are showing us for that. We showing it just to follow the step of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, right? And it's very important you have this, right? Because khalas, you are nothing now, right? You have, because you need to bring money, you need to bring something, the book of dua. So this kind of, right? So what you have to do is just wearing like this. Yeah. So everything here, right? It's very, very important for men, and also make something, buy something is very thick, because something is, right? And also I encourage you, don't bring green card, bring something that's important. Don't think that Makkah is safe. There's a group of people, they come to Makkah just for stealing. You have to be careful. People mostly in Jamarat were not aware somebody was, right? It's not mean in general, you know, alhamdulillah safe, but we have to be careful, right? Even if you bring money, not too much. That's what you need, right? So that's so woman is very simple. The woman ihram, it is good, you know, in wearing a white, but it's not necessary. Because white is a symbol of purity, cleanliness, and you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? So this kind of cloth, it is good to wearing, yeah? But you can wearing other color also, right? During the ihram. And also make sure that the cloth is open, right? So people cannot see the body, yeah? So women as such do not have an ihram clothing like the men, like the men do, but Muslim ladies need to adhere to basic Islamic dress code like wearing an abaya, right? This only during the umrah and during the hajj, and then the rest you can wearing whatever you want, right? When instead of ihram for ladies, the face should not be covered, but the head and body need to be covered. So basically, in general, I mentioned before, what's the ihram of men? The head. The ihram of men, the head. The man cannot what? Cover the head. So we cannot, after wearing kufi or wearing ihram, you're wearing the kufi like this. Right? Yeah. And yesterday, Sheikh Abdul Hakim quick was mentioned, you know, and very interesting, if you are in Makkah, you will see people wearing their uniform. Not during the ihram, of course. You know, you can notice, oh, this is from Nigeria. This is from Indonesia, because you can see them. And then he said, if you see somebody was mixed, the kufi from Nigeria, the cloth from Afghanistan, the shoes from this, he said, this is Americans. This is American. The American just have to follow the right. So that's about the ihram and the significance of the ihram. Sure. Yes. Yeah, the shoes have to be the important, the toes in the front and the ankles open. So what type of shoes is okay? As long as two things open, the toes, right, and the ankle. Yeah, it's better. Sometimes you I think I saw in the pictures last week that you're wearing something that when you run, it's okay for you. I will show you again, inshallah. Right. I think you have it in. Yeah. Yeah, good. I just want to show this exactly what I got to show. Yeah. So this is good during the hajj time, because you're going to walk a lot. Because sometimes you're wearing a green sandal, people step on this big, and maybe they cut off you. But this one is protect you good. You can run, you can, right? So this is the type that I need you to bring two, Because when you go masjid regularly, you don't need this one. This one during the time that you do hajj. Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah.
And then, what is the best dhikr or what we have to do after you wearing ihram? Just one thing. What's that? Talbiyah. Yeah? See after me, inshallah. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik. Labbaik la sharika laka labbaik. Innal hamda wa ni'mata laka wal mulk. La sharika lak. Right? You can see that the meaning of the talbiyah. But what is the significance of talbiyah? Number one, to feel a connection with all other created beings. Look at the beautiful hadith. There is no Muslim who recite the talbiyah, but whatever is to his right and to his left of stone, rock, you know, cloud, recite with him. Allah. So therefore, when Rasulullah ﷺ was walking, you know, and making labbaik, Jibril came, Muhammad asked them to raise their voice. Why? Because that prophet's father, he can hear also, right? SubhanAllah. The same when, you know, when you are in jungle, you call Adhan, you know, that the trees, the river, that hear your Adhan, become witness in the Jannah. Right? And also, talbiyah, the symbol of tawhid. You know, innal hamda wa ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika lak. All praise and blessing only belong to you. Symbol of tawhid. The response is lasting and ongoing. That means I'm from now on, inshallah, Allah, I'm going always labbaik. Labbaik for fajr, labbaik to come to masjid, labbaik to the Quran. So labbaik, labbaik, I will respond to your calling. Before, sometimes I'm lazy. So I'm near, I'm going to always say labbaik. You know, it's lasting and continue, right? And also mean continuous servitude to Allah. Allah, I'm your slave, I will serve you, I'm obedient to you. Yeah, the symbol of love and respect. You know, when somebody call you, how you respond? Depend who call you, right? If the one whom you love, how you call? Yes sir, yes sir, right? So who call you now? Lord of the world. So therefore, even you know the inanimate, when Allah give him able to talk, even the animal, they say the same. One time Abu Jahal came, he brought a lizard. Ya Muhammad, you know, are you prophet yet? So what do you want? He have lizard, a dog. I say, can you talk to dog? Qala ya dog, man ana. Rasulullah said, dog, who am I? Qala labbaika wa sa'adik ya Rasulullah. He said, labbaika wa sa'adik ya Rasulullah. Responding to the calling whom you love. Right? So therefore, if your mom, your dad call you, you don't say, what? Labbaik, mommy. Labbaik, right? Oh, in our language, yes, yes. Right? That's very important. Acknowledging that all praise and all sovereignty belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Innal hamda wal mulka lillah. Right when you said it. Yeah. So therefore, next time when you say talbiyah, you have to have this in your mind about love, about servant, right? A symbol of tawheed you have to put in your mind. So therefore, understanding the meaning is very important about the hajj, about the talbiyah. And then tawaf. What is the significance of tawaf? Number one, when Allah SWT did forgive, He going to forgive Adam, Allah said, Adam, I will not forgive you unless you build my house. So Adam built a house. You know very interesting? In the Quran said, Inna awwala baytin wudiya linnasi lalladhi bibakka. The first house Allah built, appointed what is in Bakkah. We have Makkah and what? We have Bakkah. Allah mentioned also the word Makkah a lot in the Quran. But specifically, when Allah talk about Kaaba, He said, I build Kaaba on the Bakkah. What's the difference? Bakkah is the spot where Kaaba is sitting. So that means you cannot move the Kaaba. So Allah SWT remind us, never move the Kaaba. That's the spot of Kaaba. Because mine might be, oh man, you know, why is it? You know, it's too crowded and well, let me move Kaaba to the area where it's easier. So Allah said, no, it's here, it's the Kaaba. Because if you put a rope between Kaaba and Baitul Ma'mur in the seventh heaven, it's exactly. Yeah. A Kaaba also is a symbol of Tawheed. You know, you pray now, what direction now you pray? Northeast, right? From America. But from Indonesia, Japan is west. Right? But in, when you are in Kaaba, where are your direction? You know, sometimes you ask the student, when you can pray to any direction? And the answer is, when you are in front of Kaaba, you can be here. The unity, everybody focus on that. Right? No. When you make Tawaf, where will be the Kaaba? On your left or your right? On your left, right? Yeah. Why on your left? Because the heart is here. Al-Qalb. So when you be careful, Tawaf is not physical. Your body only move, but you have to connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your heart. So therefore when you said the Kaaba, what the sunnah when you say the Kaaba the first thing? Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, right? You see Kaaba, but you connect your heart with Allah, the Lord of the Kaaba. Right? So therefore one time I was in the masjid and the Sheikh was reading in Fajr. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ I almost cried. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ Let them worship the Lord of the house. Allah. Before here, you don't see it. And now you are in Makkah. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ Let them worship the Lord of this Kaaba. And you are there. Your heart will be connected. Right? Now, why Tawaf, you know, you run like this, not like this, right? No, if you go to restroom and you open the faucet, you want water, you do like this or like this? Like this, right? So this go up and the water go down. If you go like this, what happen? You close it, right? So therefore, Tawaf means you elevated yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah shower you with the rahmah. Right? Shower you with the rahmah. So therefore when you are making tawaf, you have to make sure that in Arabic, in the Egyptian saying, Ana wala haka. I am nothing. Be careful, right? You can see people make tawaf, some really enjoy and cry. Some, he just like make exercise. You understand what I mean? Depend on what? Depend on your heart. Right? I remember I told the story. Imam Ahmad, he was a man from Africa. He make tawaf. The first three, he just said, Ya Allah, ana miskin, I am miskin, my wife miskin, my kid miskin, I wearing miskin clothes. And after finished tawaf, Imam Ahmad brought a sack of money. You know, I give to him. I said, what for this? Because you are miskin. I said, Wallahi, I am the richest one in Africa. I am the richest one. I said, why you say I am miskin? He said, the only way I can connect to Allah, I can cry after I put down myself. Because I am rich. I still have feeling. Allah said, I am looking. And he said, after the third one, he cried. Right? So you have to forget yourself, who you are. Right? Then you can feel the sweetness of the tawaf. Right? So, and also, when you do tawaf, that means what? You are in harmony with this universe. Because everything in the set of tawaf. The moon, they're moving around what? The earth moving around what? The sun, well, the galaxies. And continue always in moving. Right? So you are in harmony with the Kaaba. Right? With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the greatest connection with the Kaaba is performing Hajj and doing tawaf around it. So that means that when you go to over there, because in the Hadith said, "Min aysari ma yu'to min man yandur ila Kaaba an yu'ti Allah bi kulli nadr hasan wa yumhi anhu sayyi'a wa yarfa'u lahu daraja." Subhanallah. So when you go to Makkah, you know, they have certain reward. The best reward, what? When you make tawaf. What second reward? You still get reward. But look at Kaaba. So look at Kaaba is ibadah. So after you finish, for example, tawaf, you know, you're sitting in masjid, just look at Kaaba. Look at this. For every look at Kaaba, Allah give you what? One hasanah. Allah remove what? One bad deed. And Allah SWT elevate the hasanah. Subhanallah. Yeah? So looking at Kaaba is ibadah, right? So finish that, and then we do about sa'i. Sa'i is symbol of iman, tawakkal, and yakin and ikhlas, right? No, remember that Ibrahim alayhi salam left Hajar where? In a valley where there is no what? There is no water. No what? No trees, no food. You know, there is a couple is from Indonesia. It's a true story. He have twins. They love their twin. Right? Everything was ready. Passport was there, about to leave. And his wife said, "No, I cannot leave them." And the husband said, "You're going to leave your twins in the good hand, with your mom, your family." And Ibrahim alayhi salam have to live there. In the wilderness. So alhamdulillah, because of the story, I said, okay, we go. Right? And you all, many of us maybe, you know, have small children. You know, this is very important. Because sometimes you have something in your mind, oh man, what's going to happen to me? What's going to happen to my children? So remember this. Ibrahim alayhi salam have to leave them in. This is death, right? What's going to happen? This is death for us. But for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ibrahim. So therefore, when Ibrahim about to leave, what Hajar said? "Honey, where are you going?" He just walked away. "Where are you going?" Three times, right? You know the story. And they said, "Did Allah ask you to leave?" He said, "Yes." What he said? "Allah will not betray me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not leave us alone." This is what? Iman. That's iman. Khalas. Allah has to do, go. Iman. And then what? He put his hand, his heart with what? Tawakkal. Trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. "Allah, I trust you. You know, you will take care of me." We'll talk about tawakkal inshaAllah. And then what? Yakin. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked my husband to leave, and I have yakin that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide us. Right? And then what the last one? Ikhlas. Sincerity. This is the probation that all of us have to bring during the Hajj. Without this, you'll be not successful. You have to have iman, right? Tawakkal. Because tawakkal, you get to leave what? Behind everything. Your children, your money, your wealth, everything. The only trust you give to whom? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? So, what happened to Hajar? Now, even he have these four, but Hajar did not forget one thing. What's that? Huh? Sunnatullah. Allah set up the sunnah, the law. Sunnatullah means if you want to have baby, what you need? Marry first, right? Not just go to masjid, oh, look, baby. You didn't marry, not yet. Right? You want to be a doctor, you have to study. That's sunnatullah. So therefore, somebody said, why American and Japanese more advanced in technology? Because of what? They follow sunnatullah. To be disciplined, study hard, this is sunnatullah. Right? So, Hajar, she knew that everything need what? Okay, if you want to get something, you need what? You need an effort. What the? Effort. What in Arabic effort mean? Sa'i. Sa'i mean what? Effort. He know Allah SWT will going to give him water, but he need what? So therefore what he did? He was walking from Safa to Marwa. Why he used the heel of Safa? What Safa mean? What Safa mean? Pure. Sa'i is effort. Safa mean pure. You get to make effort. You want to do business. You get to get married. You have to start from what? From halal, from pure. This is the lesson. Any effort you do for business, for marriage, whatever, start from what? Halal. So therefore, during the Hajj time, a man was beside the Prophet. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik. The Prophet said, la labbaik wa la sadiq. Rasulullah, why? He said, how could Allah accept his Hajj? Everything that he brought is from haram. His food haram, his clothes haram. Like somebody was somebody he won lottery, go to Hajj. You do corruption, go to Hajj. That's not Safa. So every time you do, this is the land lesson. Safa wal Marwa. Now the question to you. Did her effort produce result or not? Not from her. Because after finish 7 times, so that means she did maximum. Tired of it. It's no water. Then Allah SWT give water from where? From the heels of the babies. Helpless. Allah said, you just make effort. Right? I will bring you from sources that not in your mind, beyond your imagination. Right? So therefore, when you do sa'i, remember who? Hajar. And Hajar have 4 qualities. What's that? Iman, tawakkal, yakin, and ikhlas. Right? And then we go to Arafat. This is the most important in Hajj, inshallah. The word Arafat means no one. Why they call Arafat? 3 reasons for Arafat. Number one, I said, because this is the meeting between Adam and Hawa. When Allah expelled Adam and Hawa, where did Adam land? In India. Right? And when is Hawa landed? In Jeddah. They call Jeddah mean grandmother, right? So Hawa is closer. So that means Adam have to walk so far from India. That's before earthquake, before he can walk from, right? So then they're walking, and both of them are looking for another. No cell phone, nothing, right? Why you go on with another? There's nothing. Then Allah SWT let them meet again where? In Arafah, Ta'arafah, they knowing again. That's number one. Number two, Arafat, because Jibril did teach Ibrahim about Hajj, Manasikul Hajj. Right? Ibrahim bring Ihram, you know, Budumina and all this. And then in Arafat, Jibril asked, Hal Arafta? Do you know now? Ibrahim said, Arafta. Right? So he knowing the Manasikul Hajj. The other meaning of Arafat, that means in Arafat you recognize the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know who's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because 3 million people come to that place only for Him. They're going to say the same word, wearing the same clothes. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika lak. That you are small, you are nothing. This is the place that you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? So inshallah we'll elaborate again about Arafat when we are there, inshallah. Right? And then Mina, I mentioned that Mina, which is between the holy city of Makkah and Muzdalifah. Look at here when you see Mina, this is Makkah and Muzdalifah. So therefore the closest place from Makkah is Arafat. Mina, Muzdalifah is very close. Right? Mina. And Mina means hope. This is the place that you put hope. In Mina, what we do, what the most important in Mina. What the most important in Mina? Huh? Jamarat. This is to tell us lesson that you're going to face the enemy every day. So in Mina, you know, before you go to Mina, you go to Muzdalifah. What you do in Muzdalifah, you sleep there, but also you pick up what? The power.
Why in Muzdalifah? You know, sometimes if you're going to fight against the enemy, what do you have to do? You have your tactic, right? So you're hiding now. Take out the bubbles. Right? It's hiding. Right? And then you go back to Mina, and you're ready with the weapon. Right? But when Ibrahim Allah said, why this tree? Because when Ibrahim come to this place, Shaitan came wearing turban. Ibrahim, your dream is not true. It's not from Allah, from devil. Yeah. What did Ibrahim do? What did? He stole it. Right? Did Shaitan give up? Shaitan go to second place. Do the same again. Shaitan give up? No. So, but remember when you're stalling, you're not stalling, this is only symbol. You have to make intention, I want to get rid of him when I come back to America. You know, I cannot wake up in the morning, Fajr. From now on, I will get him. I always get tempered with my husband, with my wife. Right? I will put him down now. Right? Because some people sometimes just, fast. Even some people took the sandal. And it's the way. Right? Even some people sometimes they didn't have this kind of feeling. So Jamarat is a symbol. The intention that you, like Ibrahim alayhi salam, successful? No. Did Shaitan give up? Where do you go? His son with him, right? Ismail. Your dad is crazy. You know, you're still young. Enjoy your life, right? Alhamdulillah, Ibrahim, yes, he cannot, do something to Ismail. No, did Shaitan give up?
No.
No, where do you go? To his wife. Ibrahim's wife. Hajar! El Haji. I said, Hajar, your husband is crazy, no? What? You're going to kill your son. He's the only son. What Hajar said? He said, no one loved my son more than my husband. Look at him. So Shaitan, the same will come to you through different ways, right? So that's, I think, done. And then the last one will be the Tawaf Wada. It is like also the protocol, the etiquette to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before you leave Makkah, you have to say something. Like you, when you somebody invite you, before you leave, you say, Jazakallah khair, thank you very much. It's the same also, Tawaf al-Wada. So that's the secret or spiritual thing about the Hajj. We hope that we understand, and we inshallah, next time when you go to, and inshallah, when we start doing all the Hajj, you have this kind of feeling. Because knowing the ahkam, the ruling, is good, it's very important. But I wanted also you feel it. Because ibadah without feeling is like robots. Right? Even not only it is, even salat. You know why make wudu before salat? He said when you make wudu for salat, it's not like you washing your face. You make intention, Ya Allah, I wash my hand and I promise I'm going to clean my hand from anything that's not good. When you wash your mouth, what it means? Ya Allah, I will not call name, backbiting, I want to clean. Because clean spiritually, the same the face. I want not to do as this is the meaning of the cleaning. You know. So therefore Imam Shafi'i, he was 70, his teeth never changed. His eyes, you know, I had to use glass. He said, because I protected when I was young. So Shafi'i when he make wudu, not only put the water, he make the incense to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He make an oath with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I clean physically, but I'm going to clean spiritual. Right? So inshallah we will see you next high training, and hope on that day we'll get your passport and everything. Yeah, my wife will update you inshallah. Yeah. Any question before we close? Yes. I will send you. Yeah, I will send you. You know, inshallah when you go back you will see it all in your computer inshallah. Right. Any other questions? Yes.
Some people are sensitive to light.
Yeah, you can use the sunglasses. Yeah, yeah. You can use sunglasses, also you can use the mask. What you call it? Mask, yeah. You can use that one. And any can that connected to medicine is okay. Even shoes. If you have problem with your knee, you don't wearing shoes, you will hurt, you can wearing shoes. Right? You can wearing medicine. For example, something I have something headache, you put that, it's okay. You can eat medicine. Anything connected with medical is okay. Right? During the hard time. Yeah? Anything else? And also the same, the underwear for men, if you have problem, you can wear it. Yeah. Okay, the question, we're living on Jum'ah, we're going to pray Jum'ah, not Jum'ah, right? On that day, because the flight, I think, leaving at 1 o'clock. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, you just pray Dhuhr, right? So we pray Dhuhr and Asr, right? I think we'll be on the plane. Yeah. Yes?
You said we can make Dhuhr many times, but any time we can make Dhuhr, it has to be 7 times?
7 times, good. Can we make tawaf every time? Yes. You know, if you're not tired, you know, you go to masjid, you have to make tawaf. It's good to make tawaf, not at daytime, at night time, because there's a heat. And also the construction is not finished yet, so something.
But it has to be 7.
Have to be 7. Have to be 7. 9. Yes. Huh? Talbiyah, yeah? Yeah, the woman. Woman also to talbiyah, but not like men. You don't need to raise the voice. Only you can hear it. Not only like this. No, like the bank, along the bank. So you can hear by yourself, right? Yes.
Can we do umrah for somebody else?
Can we do umrah for somebody else? Yes. If somebody that who died already, you can do umrah for them, right? So you get to have second umrah, for sure. Because from Makkah, you go to Medina before the Hajj. And then from Medina, we go back to Makkah, that you can do Umrah. And you can do Umrah that for anybody. Or for example, at night, right? Like Brother Abdul Qadir over there, he make Umrah every night. He's very strong. But you don't...
Two a day. Every two Umrah a day.
Two Umrah one day? SubhanAllah. He's still young, yes. No. For Umrah? Yeah, yeah. Anytime you do Umrah, have to be Tawaf and Sa'i. Anytime you do Umrah, have to be there is Tawaf and Sa'i. Always like that. You know. But only not Umrah, only Tawaf, no Sa'i. So therefore, you will not see people in the Sa'i place not wearing Ihram. You understand me? You will never see people in the Sa'i place, no ihram. But you will see a lot of people making tawaf without ihram. Because tawaf anytime, right? Yes?
Do you need to go to Miqat?
Yes, good. In order to do umrah, you have to go to Miqat. Because you are now like the people of Makkah, citizen of Makkah, Nawalis. And your Miqat is to go to Masjid Aisha. That's the closer. Masjid Aisha, there's a bus go there, you know, you pray to rakat there and you come back to Makkah and Tawaf, right? But you cannot, you do umrah from your hotel. But on the hard time, you make intention from your hotel. You are become Makkah now, right? You're not wearing ihram now, and tomorrow you go to Mina, and then you're wearing ihram, and you don't need to go to Masjid Aisha. Only for Umrah. Another place is called Girona. It's a little far, right? And it's transportation very easy. Especially at night, if you have 5 people, just rent taxi and ask them to wait and then bring it back. Right? We will organize it, inshallah. Yeah. Yes?
Will you be providing Ihram?
The providing, no. We have Ihram for sale.
Okay.
Yeah, we have. Very good. If you forget how many years, 6 or 7, right? You know. But in Tawaf, you can discuss. Ask your wife, how many? I think 7. No, 6. You can discuss. Yeah. But what you have to do if you are still confused, like salat, the same. If you pray Isha, it should be after 4 or 3. What you have to do? Why do 3? Because 3 is yakin. You don't 4. The same with tawaf. Tawaf, right? If you forget, take the last one. 6 or 7? Just 6. I said, no, 7. No, 6. Yeah? Take the last one. It's okay even after finish. Oh man, you are 8. It's okay. Right? No sujud sahwi. Right? No sujud sahwi for that. Yes, it's not Maliki, it's all the madhab. I mean, according to hadith, when you make tawaf, you have to have wudu. He said, tawaf is like salat. Only what? What is different? You can talk. But you mean there's a talk, then you talk about business. Oh, what is it? No, that means you can talk, there's something necessary. Because something is, your wife is lost. Hey, come here. It's okay. You can bring them back. Right? So, salat, tawaf, they have to have wudu. So therefore, you know, when you do during the hajj time, don't too much eat spices like Indian biryanis and you know. Because it is very important. Because if you have to do something, you have to go far. You get to cut off from the group. We cannot wait for you, right? You have to go outside. That's to make. Right? Wudu is okay, maybe over there we can zam-zam if wudu, come back. But you do number one, number two, you are in trouble. Right? And also, by the way, I advise it very important, food is very important. In Mina Arafat, make sure you don't eat something that, because you go to the restroom, you're wasting your time, not for dua, just waiting in the restroom. Yeah? Yeah. So inshallah, we hope that make dua, that we have good news and bad news, bad news, you know. There's some problem with the Saudi website from Makkah, not from here. So all Makkah, Europe, I mean Indonesia, Europe, the US, and the Saudi cannot do nothing. You know, I remember the Obamacare problem with the website. It's the same like that. They tried a new thing, but it's not like this. Alhamdulillah, last Friday, alhamdulillah, everything's off. So inshallah, this Monday we'll process all our visa inshallah. And everything will be easy because everything, my wife have to work so hard, have to put all your data in the computer. So when they go there, they just look at the number, they will come out all about information about you, and then they issue the visa, right? Yes? Before Ihram, yes. Aisha, you put the henna. Radiallahu anha, his wife, we put the henna before the... We meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's just like this. Huh? Yeah, but before, okay, the question, before, yes, you can put the oil, it's not haram. You can put the lotion, you know, sometimes. Yeah, you can use the, I'm sorry, huh? It's very important for a specific man, because you're going to... If people, and then you wake up, people from, right? So, something that, and then after you make intention, khalas. And very careful, because you go down, if you go from hotel, people are selling the perfume. And people something forget, like, Ihram, you have to pay down if you put the perfume, right? Khalas. So, for the man, you can put perfume for your ihram also, before you make intention, right? So, inshallah, see you next week, right? Yes? No, ihram only for umrah and hajj. Yeah, cover back. That's all, just. Okay, make dua insyaAllah. Alhamdulillah, fi ni'mah wa fi masjid ya Rabbana lakal hamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhika wa azimi sultanik. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi washabbi ajmain. Allahumma taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alaina innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Allahumma la sahla illa ma ja'atahu sahla. Allahumma sahil umur hajjina. Allahumma yassir wa la tu'assir ya karim. Allahumma balighna baitika al-haram wa ziyarati rasulika al-azam ya rabbal alamin. Wa sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.